Hi fellas, welcome back. I've came to see Paul. Now, you might be looking at this car thinking that is a nice clean three-door. Well, about a year ago, it was in a bit of a different state. Paul's been doing a restoration on it, mate. A bit unfortunate situation with this car.
It was, yeah, unfortunately. Fuel pressure regulator let go and dumped fuel all over the distributor and set it on fire. Yeah, it was a bit of a state, wasn't it?
It was. The lad at the time, was it Stephen?
Stephen, yeah.
Unfortunately, he didn't have any MOT on the car as well, so the insurance didn't pay out, so he's had to pull it out of his own pocket.
He has, unfortunately, yeah. I said to him, you know, if he'd booked it in for an MOT, then he would have been insured, because you're insured to drive a car with no MOT to an MOT station.
To an MOT station.
But because he's a honest gentleman, he rang the insurance company and just said, I just took it round block just to make sure it was all right before I took it for an MOT, and because it wasn't booked in, he had no they wouldn't pay out, so he's had to cough up himself.
What I will do is I'll put some footage in of the car when it first came to Paul's. It was about a year ago, wasn't it, Paul?
I think it was about a year ago, yeah.
It was sad to see, really. For me, it was sad to see, because I've got one of these as well, so seeing a burnt out one, kind of...
Yeah, when he rang me and told me it happened, you don't imagine them to be that bad either, do you? You know, you think, oh, it can't be that bad if he's sending it for repair, you know, it can't be bad. But yeah, it was especially bad for me, because we'd restored the car back in 2016 for him. He'd seen some of the work we'd done online, and because he's had this from brand new, he rang us up and said, oh, will you just tidy it up a bit? So we took engine out, did a full underbonnet restoration on it, put it back to mint, and so the car was proper nice. And then to see it come back, all your hard work burnt out. In great like.
So what's been painted on at the park? Because obviously at the beginning where you stripped it, blasted it.
Yeah, it's been all blasted, obviously, because you need to get back all the fire damage off it and all the paint off it. So we completely blasted all the inner wings, all the front chassis rails, everything. But over years, it's had little bits of paint here and there. So there's a little bit of a colour variant downsides.
Right.
So we said, while it's getting painted, you know, there was a couple of dints downside, you know, just general marks for being 30-odd year old. So we decided we painted down both sides of the car. So it's had, but the only thing that hasn't been painted really is the roof, the tailgate and spoiler and the back panel. Everything else and the back bumper, all down the sides, has been painted. We haven't painted the rear wheel arch spats either, because there was nothing wrong with them.
The arch?
Yeah, the arches, but they all came off to be painted. You know, we don't mask things up. Mm-hmm. So they all came off. We took all the mouldings off. So it's had all brand new side mouldings on, because obviously the wing ones were buckled anyway. So it's had a lot of paint. It's had, panel-wise, obviously it's had a pair of brand new wings. Now, originally, my plan was to save the wings, because they weren't bad. This one was, you know, I'd taken all the paint off, as you'll see on some earlier pictures, all the paint had been lifted off. But I wanted to really save the wings if we could. But when we took body kit off, they were quite rotten, you know, down bottom edge where they weld on. They were really rough there, and I sort of could have maybe fabricated bits and welded them in, but I spoke to Stephen and said, do you know what? While we're at this stage, it'll be easier to take wings off to blast all the back edge of inner wings where paint was damaged. It was a bit crusty as well, you know where brackets are at front here, where bumper mounts on, they rot bad there.
It's a pretty common place them to go, isn't it?
Yeah, it was a bit crusty there, so I thought, do you know what? By the time you start welding that up, and then obviously a bit of filament wings, because they were a little bit buckled, I could have planished them somewhat like straight. So we just said, do you know what, let's put wings on it.
Put some wings on.
So it's, as I say, it's had bonnet wings, grill,
wings.
Bumper, yeah, genuine Ford wings. This is the original wheel arch, but we've repainted that. It's had a second-hand bumper.
Struggled to get a bumper as well, didn't you?
£1,200 we paid for that bumper.
For a three-door bumper?
For a three-door, £1,200.
Mad.
But the thing with these are harder now to find than RS500.
Because they weren't worth now years ago, were they?
No. Everybody put them on track cars and things and rammed people. But this is a new wheel arch on this side, because obviously it was melted, it was completely missing, was this one. So that's a second-hand wheel arch. But there's two reasons why this is taking so long, really. One is, obviously, I have other jobs in the workshop to do. So I have to fit around people's, you know, like when it goes for paint, I have to book it in, and when he can do it and blah, blah, blah. But buying parts for this has been an absolute nightmare. It really has.
I know. We'll put the bonnet, have a look under the...
Yeah, and people, you know, when you buy stuff off them, you trust them, and they tell you, oh, it's mint.
Aye, it's not when you get it. God, it looks mint under their mind. It won't have been this clean from you, will it?
No, I doubt it.
Look at down there.
Obviously, it was painted, as a previous video shows. There was, obviously, the car was completely stripped from The back seat's forward. There wasn't a single thing in the car. Everything was taken out. The only thing left in was the back axle, the headlining, the tailgate and the rear bumper. Because all the interior had to come out because we changed the complete car loom. Because obviously the car loom was burnt, was damaged. And I wasn't going to join the loom, you know, like some people join it halfway down and put... I just thought, do you know what, for the sake of taking a bit of back seats and a bit of trim out. So we fitted a complete car loom, a new engine bay, well not new, but a second-hand engine bay loom, which I managed to get off a mate of mine off a car he broke many, many, many years ago.
Just mint mind. You've done a mint job.
I'm pleased with it.
The lad's driving a bat as well, isn't he? He's going to drive a bat.
Yeah, he wants to drive it home, yeah.
How far is it for him? About an hour or two?
Yeah, just an hour and a half, something like, depending on traffic. Nice. But he uses it, so...
No, well, why not? It's not going to do it no harm, is it? And that was the culprit, wasn't it? Obviously, that's an aftermarket one from Vantage Performance.
Yeah, tell you what, the amount of people now...
Buying them?
Yep. They must be the most best thing to have in stock for a cosy. The amount of people who are, well, we were at the NEC, weren't we, at the Classic Show. The amount of people who have said to me, since that video on that burnt out 3-door, I put a new fuel pressure regulator on.
Don't mind, now. Is that a 500 one, what you've blanked on?
Yeah, I just put a blank in the front. I even went to MOT station yesterday with this car, and the guys who I use, Chris and Adam, said they'd had a black Sapphire in a few weeks ago for a couple of running issues, and his fuel pressure regulator started leaking yesterday.
Really?
He says it was absolutely gushing it out fuel, so he was lucky.
Because what happens is it leaks out here, doesn't it, Paul? Then it goes on your distributor.
That's right, yeah.
Obviously the sparks.
Well, the original one, I made in two pieces. This is a one-piece casting. Uh-huh. The original one's made in two pieces, and it's where it's joined on that ring there. It weeps the fuel out of there when the diaphragm goes. Like I say, it drops it straight onto the distributor. Or sprays it out under the bonnet somewhere, and the heat ignites it.
But that's mint.
I'm lucky I had some good friends help me. I met a man, Simon Hur. He sent me that bulkhead panel. And that was as
described.
Yeah, I was. That was as described. It was mint, you know, not the usual. I bought headlamps, header tank, a couple of bottles, and that off a lad from Scotland. I'm terrible with names. It's gone, but he'll come back to me. He helped me out with them. Got a Vintag brand new. Had that done by Dave Lee at XYZ Fabrications. He makes them new tags.
Nice.
Because obviously the original one was melted. So he did that for us. Obviously, there's Dibsy who did all the paintwork. Jorvik Windscreens, they put the glass in for me, supplied and fitted the glass with all new rubbers.
The JC Aqua Blasting as well?
That's it, JC. He did all the aluminium bits for us, blasted all them.
They look painted, they look mint mine, don't they, then?
They look great, don't they, when he's done them? And then what I do with them, I just put a coat on, a light coat of a matte lacquer.
Right.
And does, you can touch it, normally if you touch bare alloy with your fingers, it leaves marks. But if you put a coat of matte lacquer on, it doesn't mark it.
Just stops them oxidising.
Yeah, so he did that for us.
No, it looks mint, I'll drop mine off.
Roos Motorsport supplies us with all the OE looking brand new hoses. You know, because obviously most Samco ones and that you buy are all glossy. Well, Roos Motorsport, he supplies me with all the hoses I ever use. He does all the matte finish original ones. He reproduced the big breather one, that one. He's done that and does that one in the correct colour.
I was going to mention that. That's the original colour.
Yeah, it's like a proper colour.
No, it looks mint, mate. Looks mint. I'm sure Stephen will be happy with it.
He better be. Yeah, it's a long time and a lot of money. I mean, fair play to him. I haven't actually added it up what it cost, but I would estimate somewhere around 30 grand he spent on it.
30 grand? Mm. A lot of that is going to be in parts, isn't it? Like you say, grand enough for bumper, then wings.
Yeah,
I mean,
a bonnet.
A wing, 500 quid each?
Yeah, 500 each. A bonnet's 500-600 quid now. You know, windscreen. Engine's been fully rebuilt from
full
top to bottom.
Full engine rebuild, aye.
Because we took it out and I gave it to Paul Bulmer, who does road car engines for me. And I said to him, look, take it to bits and see what you think. It might be fine. Anyway, he took it to bits and he said, do you know what? It's not bad. It hasn't actually done any damage, but it's done 60,000 miles. It's in bits. Mm-hmm. Do you put it back together? So I rang Stephen and he said, no, just... So it's had, you know, new pistons in it, all new shells, everything. So engine's...
Just standard part internally, though,
not upgraded. No. And then Phil Allenby, he does rocker covers for us.
That's mint, that rocker cover. I keep looking at that.
Nice, isn't it?
It is nice.
what he does, he paints, he blasts them. Well, JC Aquablasting blasted that for us, and then Phil paints them, and then he has the machine for skimming them off.
Uh-huh.
And so he does that for us.
That does look nice, that.
He's always done mine for, as Phil, because if you look, a lot of people, when they paint them, they do them gloss.
Mine
and,
is?
Yeah, and they're not supposed to be. They're supposed to be matte like that.
That's why I was looking at that, thinking I want mine like that.
Just how they came from new, they look better.
No, it does, it does. Mine was done 10 years ago. Our lass's dad took it to work for us. I blasted it. And then I took it to work and machined it on the machines at work. No, but it does look mint, Paul.
Looks yeah, I'm really pleased. Nice. Even got an original flat terminal battery on it now. Because everybody's converting them to round ones. And they just don't look right, do they?
No. No, it looks nice. Looks really nice. That's it, fellas. Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of what Paul gets up to, there's a couple of videos looking around his workshop. Very interesting. Got some cool projects in there, Paul.
I always have some on the go.
I'll leave a link to Paul's social media pages below. He's got his Instagram and two Facebook pages.
I have, yeah.
Paul Linford Racing and RS500 Owners.
That's right, yeah.
Very full of knowledgeable people as well. But yeah, again, thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Spot on, mate.
Cheers.